Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel and thanks so much for watching. Today I'm doing an Amazon haul for you guys. I've got beauty and fashion, a lot of cardigans. I did not realize it until they came in. I was like, I'd washed and dried them all and then I was hanging them up and I was like, what was I thinking? Like I bought like all cardigans. So I have a couple sweaters, a dress, but a lot of cardigans. The beauty products are really, really good. So everything I'm talking about is gonna be linked in the description bar below for you guys to shop. So make sure you check that out down there. I do link things individually, but I also have my Amazon storefront linked in the description bar as well if that's easier for you guys to shop. I also put like jewelry details, makeup details, the whole nine. It's all down there. While you're down in the description bar, go ahead and click the subscribe button. I put up a few fashion videos every single week and I'd love to have you guys join my family here on YouTube, and got a lot to share with you guys today, so let's go ahead and get started. All right, so I only have three brands, but actually a lot of products. I just bought a ton of Ilia stuff, so I'll start out with the things that are not Ilia, and the first product is such a good one. So I have said this before, the best recommendations I usually receive, they're not from like YouTubers, they're not from influencers, it's actually from you guys. And I think it might have been my July or August favorites. I think it was my August favorites. I shared that my skin was so dry and it was just like all of a sudden and I didn't really know what to do, and a bunch of you guys told me to try like multiple moisturizers, like you can stack them, and a couple of you guys actually told me to try the Clinique Moisture Surge Intense 72-hour Lipid Replenishing Hydrator underneath my regular moisturizer. So like do my regular skincare like normal and then do this and then do my like regular moisturizer, and it has made a 100% difference in my skin. So I use all my regular products. Basically, I use all Dime Beauty at this point. I use like my hyaluronic acid serum, everything. And then I go in with this. I let it kind of sit, sink in for a couple seconds. And then I go in with my Dime moisturizer. And I don't know if it's just like the combination of two moisturizers or specifically this one, but they have made a very big difference. And this one is the one that I got like multiple recommendations on. So I love this stuff. It has been a holy grail for my skin. And I hope that it, you know, sticks it out and my skin continues to behave well with it through the cooler months, because the cooler months are usually when my skin is the driest. So next I have the City Lips Plumping Lip Gloss in the color Clear. This does not plump. It doesn't burn. It doesn't plump. But I actually heard about this from Jen Reed. It is just like a clear gloss. I'm wearing it right now with a little bit of the KKW liner in, I believe it's just like number one. But this is a hyaluronic acid and peptized infused lip gloss. And so it actually, why I bought it is because Jen Reed talked about how it helped the lines in her lips. And that was something I think just like, because I've been using matte lip products for so long, I had run into. So since I've been using this, sure enough, I've noticed my lips have a much smoother appearance. So this is more like a true moisturizer for your lips that you can wear throughout the day. So very, very hydrating. It is a little bit more on the expensive side. If you don't have the lines in your lips or your lips aren't very dry, I don't think it's really something you need to like purchase. There are probably other clear glosses out there that are much cheaper, but if you do have those lines and you want to get rid of them, this is good. Okay, and then the next few products are all Ilia. I'm gonna try not to talk too much about these because I love Ilia. I've talked about them in a lot of Amazon videos because I get a lot of their stuff on Amazon because it just comes so fast. But Ilia is a clean brand. Things are a little bit more expensive there, but I am trying to transition all of my beauty and skincare routine over to like really, really clean products. And so I love Bare Minerals, but that stuff is all powder based and I did kind of want some more liquid options. So that's why I purchased these. The first I got is the, I am making messes left and right. It's the Ilia True Skin Serum Concealer in the color Yucca, Y-U-C-C-A, SC2. This is a little bit too close to the shade that I picked up in the foundation, but I am pretty good at guessing my color online. So this one is fine for my skin. I probably should have gone just maybe one shade lighter for the winter, but for the warmer months or when I'm like self-tanned, this is going to be perfect. It does have a very creamy formula to it. It has a very like easy applicator on it, very creamy formula. I'm wearing it today. Goes on smooth, doesn't crease. Very like simple and to the point. It's a great product. This is the foundation I bought. Like you guys can see, they are very similar in color. So this is the True Skin Serum Foundation. It's lightweight and smoothing, aloe infused. So it is very lightweight, but I did find that you can kind of build it. I've used it a couple times, and anytime I go back in with like a second layer, I do find that it is a little bit more full coverage. So buildable, but it is a very lightweight option. I got this in the color, oh, their names are crazy, Formentera in SF1, and this is a good color for my skin right now. This definitely would not work for my tanner skin, but you do need to shake it before you use it, because the very first time I used it, I did it, and it was really, really watery, so it does have a little bit of a thicker consistency, but you're gonna have to give it a good shake before you use it. I am always on the lookout for a good primer, because I think primer and setting spray can just, like, really make any products, honestly, it helps any products out there. So this is the True Skin Radiant Priming Serum. It's firming and smoothing and aloe infused. Smells really good. What I do like about the products, none of them smell like chemicals. And that's not something I run into a lot with makeup, but you know what, like, foundation just smells like? These smell like very fresh and earthy, just like very clean, which is good because it is a clean brand. But again, you have to shake this one before you use it, but I have been super, super pleased with this one. Probably of all the Ilia products I've ever used, this is one of my favorites. This is the Fades Into You Soft Focus Finishing Powder. This is a really good powder. It's not super thick. I would say it's like a definitely lightweight kind of setting powder, and it does say that you might have to apply it a couple times throughout the day. So I actually use this as my like setting powder later. So I don't use it when I set my makeup in the morning. I'll use it if I like need a little touch up in the afternoon. A little bit goes a long way. It does come out white, but it is fully translucent when you spread it on your face. So that's a really good powder. And I like that, again, it's just a clean product. Like, if you look up how many powders have talc in them, whew. And then the two like eye products I got, this is the Dusk Clean Line Gel Liner, and I have this on today. I don't love like any liner on, really. I just use a little bit of it to kind of thicken my waterline, because otherwise my eyes look very big and open, and I feel like this just gives them a little bit more dimension. But it is a brown color. It's the color Dusk. Very simple. It does seem to be waterproof. I haven't like jumped in a pool or anything, but it is not like, does not smear throughout the day. So I was very impressed with that. I'm always looking for a good, just like easy to apply eyeliner. And this is actually, so okay, if you are focused only on clean products, this is a really good brow gel. However, I feel like there are much better brow gels out there, but they're not clean. So this is the Essential Brow Natural Volumizing Brow Gel. It is good. I feel like my brows stay all day. Dime recently did just come out with one. I believe it is sold out right now. That one's really good too. It keeps your brows glued like all day long, and it also promotes growth, which is kind of maybe why I promote that one a little bit more. But again, like, if cleanness is something you are concerned about, then definitely go with this one. I just think like there are definitely better ones out there. Like Benefit is better, Anastasia Beverly Hills is better, but those aren't cleaner alternatives. So good, but not the best. This guy literally just opened up. I swear it waits till I'm filming to start raining. It waits, it knows. Okay, so you guys know I shoot you straight about reviews, and honestly, I don't even have the desire to really style this one cute, because this is supposed to be an oversized sweater, and I wanted to share it because I love the print. This is a large, extra large. Like, do you see the sleeve length? Like, what? So I'm probably going to be giving this to my mother, because it does not, it shrunk way too much, and it honestly just shrunk in the wash. I washed it the way it said to wash. It already came in less oversized than it said it, or it like looked online. But when I washed it, I like hung it up and I was like, that looks really short. Like, I wonder if maybe when it dries, it'll, you know, kind of get a little bit longer. Like, do you see the sleeve length? So I'm going to be giving this to my mom. She has a short torso and short arms, and it will look adorable on her. But for me and my 5'9" self and my super long torso, it ain't happening. I just wish it did, because I love the print. And apart from the fit, you guys, like, it is such a comfortable sweater. It's not at all see-through. I mean, not itchy, but yeah, this is not happening for me this fall. Okay, so now comes the long list of cardigans that I have. This one, so it's kind of hard to see the colors. I feel like this is a little bit more yellow in person. And then it has like a same, you know, little yellow patch there, but it's got like white, brown, gray on it. Very structured cardigan. I think this would actually look great for like business casual. I just have it styled with a tank top, you know, and leggings, but you could definitely wear this for work. The one thing I don't love about it is you can see this side is ribbed and then this side isn't, but it has this seam down right here that like makes it kind of lay a little bit funny. So do just keep that in mind when you are purchasing it, that it does have, you know, a seam on this side and not on this side. And for all cardigans, I did get my true size, unless they were like a one size fits all, but I always get my true size in cardigans because cardigans are open. So very, very comfortable, extremely soft. And again, I just feel like, I mean, you wear like a pair of black slacks with this, a black top, like some booties, heels. Like this is gonna be really cute for the fall time during the work day. Okay, so this leopard cardigan, I actually have seen it in past years and I've always wanted it, but it was always sold out. So when I saw it this year, I was like, yes, I need it. It is longer in the back, completely like comes to kind of a point at right at my booty there. And then in the front, it kind of does this little rise and it is a lot shorter in the front, but it is so comfortable. This feels like a Barefoot Dreams blanket. I like that the sleeves are very form-fitted too, because I feel like it adds a little bit of structure to it, but also I don't feel like this is one of those that's gonna come falling off my shoulders a lot. That is a pet peeve of mine for cardigans. So this one, again, not super long in the front. So if you are one of those people who likes to wear like crotch covering cardigans or sweaters or anything like that with leggings, this isn't gonna do it. It's only gonna cover it in the back. But again, just really comfortable and cozy. Got my true size and I think it's at a really good price point too. I can't remember off the top of my head, but I was very surprised that I found it at such a good price. Another really great long cardigan that would look nice in a business setting as well. Back when I actually used to be around people and work in an office and wasn't working from home, I actually was a big cardigan fanatic all fall and winter. This one is very long. It is a gorgeous, like mustard color. It's coming off a little bit more brown on camera, but it is cozy, fits very well. The sleeves are very form-fitted. Again, not one you're gonna find falling off your shoulders a lot, but it just has a gorgeous like structure to it, but still has like a pretty flow. No pockets, so it's not gonna like bulge out on the side or anything. This is, I almost would like, you definitely can wear this with jeans, but I would almost definitely pick this up if you're looking for like something to wear for work in the fall time. Okay, so this one is a very cozy, like casual, just throw over, very soft cardigan that I don't really feel is great for business. It's a knit cardigan coming off a little bit more gray on camera. It's a light blue. It's very, very pretty, but I like the length to this one. It is, you know, long all the way around, gonna fully cover you in the front. It does have pockets, but I would not recommend using these for anything because they do feel like they would probably get stretched out very easy just because they are so, you know, soft. But I love a good knit cardigan. You will always catch me wearing these, especially around the house during the fall and winter time. Just to show you guys also the length, it comes about, I'd say 4 to 5 inches above my knee, and I'm 5'9", so it's a very, very long. Keep that in mind if you are on the shorter side, but cozy cardigans are always a good win, especially from Amazon. And then the last like coat piece before I get onto the like top and dress I have is this green cargo jacket. So it has pockets all over it on the front. It has a collar, a zipper, and buttons. But what sold me on it is that it has drawstrings on the inside. So you're not gonna have that like awkward pull and then have these like strings hanging down. It's just gonna look a lot more slim fitted on you all the way around. The sleeve length is decent. It's not as long as I would like for it to be, but it is okay. I do need to button up that one little spot. But I did go up to a large because I saw a girl in the review section say that she's 5'9". She weighed a little bit more, I believe, than I do. She said that she felt like a large was good, not great. And so I was like, okay, I'll go with a large, specifically because of the height. And I think that was a good call. It's not something I could wear like a sweater underneath, but as far as just like a light throw over, you know, for the fall transition time, this is good. And I love a good army green color. It's becoming one of my favorite colors for fall. And it doesn't cover your booty, but you know, cargo jackets rarely do. So this is a great find from Amazon. This will most likely go down in history as one of my favorite Amazon purchases of all time. I've been looking for a top that had this layered look to it for so long that wasn't super tight, had a good length to it, and this is it. So the length to this I want to talk about first is amazing. This is a little bit more, you know,
business casual friendly. So it's not like you would necessarily be wearing leggings with it. So I don't think it's a huge deal that your butt isn't 100% covered. But it does have buttons that go all the way down the front. They are not real. And then it has this sweatshirt that is fully attached to it, but they are sewn together. This silky top is not up here. So it's like, the first half of it feels like a sweater. The second half feels like a really silky blouse. But this just seems like it would be so nice for a business setting. And the color's really great. I think they do have a lot of other colors. But as always, like, I put the color that I purchased and the size in the description bar below. Great sleeve link to it. I mean, I cannot get over this top. It would look so good with like jeans and a pair of booties too for fall. That's probably how you're gonna see me wear it a lot this year. So hands down, one of my top, like probably top five favorite Amazon purchases of all time in the fashion category. And then finally a dress. So the booties are not from Amazon, they're from Marc Jacobs. I got them at Nordstrom, but I wanted to show you guys how you could easily style this for fall. It is this gorgeous like navy blue dress with like some orange, lavender, a little bit of gray, and it does have a drawstring at the stomach and it fully buttons down in the front. So very, very pretty. I think this would be great for like a fall wedding. You could wear, you know, nicer heels with this for sure. You could wear over the knee boots with this, like a leather jacket. That would look really cute when it gets colder out, but a little bit longer in the back than it is in the front. Just very, very cozy, and it is double lined. There is a full black liner underneath it. It is a little bit shorter, but there is no part of this dress that is see-through at all, and it fits true to size. So always love being able to say that with Amazon stuff. So go ahead and grab this if you can, especially if you have anything that you're looking for this fall season, like for a wedding or even like a baby shower. This would be gorgeous for that. All right, my loves, and that is it for today's video. Kind of quick, I feel. Maybe it's not when it's all said and done, but lots of good outerwear for the fall time, which is actually, you know, one of my favorite ways to like style, you know, fall transition outfits is with just like a really good throw on jacket or something, because you can always take it off if it gets hot out. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to go below and click the subscribe button if you are new here. I love you guys so much, and I hope that I see you in my next video.